Matter is made up of atoms, and they consist of subatomic particles like electrons, protons, and neutrons. Further, we found out that protons and neutrons are made up of even smaller particles, called elementary particles. With the discovery of these elementary particles, the standard model was developed, a theory to explain these fundamental particles. Hello, cyber citizens. Welcome to What the Science, the channel where curiosity meets science. Here we discuss the science behind everything, so make sure that you are clicking the subscribe button below and the bell icon on the right of it to stay updated on sciencey stuff from our channel. So without further ado, let's get started. The standard model is the name given in the 1970s to a theory of fundamental particles and how they interact. This model divides the elementary particles into two major categories, fermions and bosons, based on the spin. Bosons have integer spins, the discovered ones have 0 or 1, while fermions have half-integer spins. Fermions are called matter particles and make up most of the mass of the visible matter in the universe. They are further classified as quarks and leptons. Quarks are the fundamental constituent of everything. They are of six different types or flavors: up, down, top, bottom, strange, and charm. The up-down quarks have the smallest masses of the six and forms majority of quark population. This is because the rest four are heavy and unstable, and they often break down to up and down quarks. Up quark has a slightly positive charge and down quark has a slightly negative. A proton consists of two up quark and one down quark, while a neutron has one up and two down. That is a brief introduction of quarks. Next up is leptons. They too have six flavors. The most famous one is an electron. Remaining five are muon, tau, and three types of neutrinos: electron neutrino, muon neutrino, and tau neutrino. Electron, muon, and tau are charged particles having a negative charge, while all types of neutrinos are neutral chargeless particles which barely interact with anything. Now coming to the other major category, bosons. Gauge bosons are force carriers, the one which causes strong, weak, and electromagnetic forces to exist and act in the way they are defined. Examples include gluons, responsible for strong forces in the nucleus of an atom, the one which keeps neutrons and protons together; W and Z bosons, the ones which carry the weak forces, the forces responsible for radioactivity, the one which causes neutrons to become protons; and photons, which carry electromagnetic force, the reason why we see things and why we are alive. Also, there is Higgs boson, which is the force carrier of the Higgs field, the one which gives a particular number to your mass depending on how strongly you interact with the field. That is the complete standard model in short, which explains most of the things, but not gravity. The major drawback of this model: gravity, according to Einstein's relativity, is warps and curves in space-time. It does not have any force carrier to do the job in the standard model. So we are on a constant search to find a new theory to unite them all. That's all from this episode. You can check out other playlists of our channel by clicking on the link above. And if you liked the episode, hit the thumbs up button. Any suggestions and ideas, please comment below. Subscribe, because we make videos every week. Press the bell icon to get notified and connect with us on other social media platforms. All the links are provided below. Thank you for watching. Hope this video created a spark in your gray cells and helped you to understand the intricacies. We will meet again soon with another video. Till then, stay curious and keep learning.